This is Harlem, a place almost everybody has heard of, but where most outsiders have never been. Every urban problem that plagues this country is represented here, and you can find it all within a few blocks of this rooftop. Broken families, rampant street crime, the worst housing this side of Calcutta, alcoholism, street gangs, and the worst plague of all, drug addiction. Almost half the population of Harlem is under 20 years old, and most kids between 16 and 20 are out of school, and most of those are out of work. Because they have not much else to do and no place else to belong, they've organized themselves into street gangs. Gangs which bear no resemblance at all to the Hollywooded tinseled version that you saw on the movie West Side Story. With names that would be comically preposterous under any other circumstances, names like the Spanish Kings or the Savage Samurai, there are 269 street gangs in this city. 36 of them are in Harlem. Ask the folks in the neighborhood about them and you'll get two stories. To some, they're the new vigilantes, scouring the streets, preying on the dope dealers that prey on the people. To others, the gangs are just so many more muggers, thieves, and bullies, ruling neighborhood territories like feudal warlords, only adding to the problems of the block. Refuge from this harsh life on the street is often found on the rooftops, and here a boy nicknamed Slick gets away from it all by presiding over a coop of 16 pigeons.
How long have you been flying your birds, Slick?
Been flying about 5 years.
How does it make you feel when you see your birds up there?
It makes me feel good.
How come?
To know that I could train them, you know? Because at first when I was starting to train them, I used to lose the birds.
And now?
Now I could train them. Now I know how to teach them. They always stay here. They never go nowhere. They always stay in their home. They don't go no other place.
How do you feel looking down on Harlem instead of being on the streets?
I don't know. It's better to be on the roof because on the street is too much trouble. Too many things going on in the street.
These sooty, graceless pigeons are the closest things these kids have to wildlife, and that almost gives the birds a certain elegance. Time for the Renegades when Roy Rosa, their president, and Rolando Gonzalez, the vice president, finally figured out that they were all running nowhere at full speed ahead. They met a building contractor, a tough ex-Marine named Tom Foscolos. Tom convinced the city government to turn over one of the hundreds of abandoned buildings in East Harlem to the gang, and now they're rehabilitating the building and their own lives.
The Renegades were first into drugs, from drugs into a big mass riot, revolution, as they would say. They started off with gun shooting, knife fights, lantana fights, chain fights. Everybody was out to get everybody else. You know, one gang to another gang, you know, mess them up, that's it, you know. They're no good. They're our enemy. Beat them up, take their colors, and destroy everything that they can see in their way. If it's something that was in their path, knock it down. They don't care what it was.
What kind of stuff are you into now?
We're rehabilitating a building over here on 119th Street and 2nd Avenue. And before that, we had built two parks in 118th Street between 2nd and 3rd. And ever since, that's what we've been doing.
Rehabilitating not only the building, but yourself.
The building, ourselves, the community, the people around us, the people that live in these slums. We're trying to help everybody.
Tom, how'd the project get started?
Project gets started because a group of people referred to as the Renegades of Harlem, Youth Gang for the People, decided to begin to rebuild their own community and have been doing so for the last 3.5 years.
Do you see what the Renegades have done with this building as a model for other street gangs in other neighborhoods and other cities?
Absolutely. You know, the street gang, the word gang is a very funny word. And if you look at what Webster has to say, it basically says a group of people working together. Now, it's unfortunate in our society, we've been taught that a gang is a destructive force. The Renegades have proven otherwise.